SSRIs, Selective Serotonin Reuptake Inhibitors. Serotonin is an inhibitory neurochemical. It lessens the intensity of a nerve impulse. It helps us dampen thoughts, which without this dampening may become compulsions. It can also dampen pain impulses, which is not its primary function, but may explain why certain antidepressant meds are used for such things like fibromyalgia. Inhibitory neurochemicals sort of have the ability to overlap each other and perform similar functions. When a person is deficient in one inhibitory neurochemical, they are typically deficient in all of them, as the other ones have likely been used up trying to compensate. These type of folks lack the ability to turn an intense impulse into a milder one. When serotonin is called upon, it comes out from the vesicles. It is released into the synapse, exerts an inhibition of the nerve impulse. It is then broken down by the serotoninase enzyme so that it can be reuptaken back into the vesicles so it can be used again later. Selective serotonin reuptake type antidepressants, which we will refer to as SSRIs, are generally not what you might regard as a mood elevator. They are more implicated in reducing the probability of someone following through on suicidal ideation. Increasing serotonin may reduce the impulsivity associated with hurting oneself or others. SSRIs could be that magic that gives someone a break from certain symptoms like impulsivity, anxiety, and sleep issues. Unfortunately, like most medications, the effect may not be sustainable, as they are not feeding the nervous system more neurotransmitters, they are spending them. And when the nervous system is completely spent, the problem could become substantially worse. SSRIs have been known to increase suicidality, which is what generated public outcry, forcing manufacturers to include a black box warning. SSRIs are thought to work by poisoning the serotoninase enzyme. The serotoninase enzyme is what allows the serotonin to be recycled. This forces the serotonin to stay in the synapse and continue to exert an inhibitory effect. If the serotonin is not reuptaken, as it should be, over time it is probable that it then breaks down into its metabolites to the point where there is no serotonin left and the vesicles are exhausted. And when there is no serotonin left to reuptake, then a reuptake inhibitor, in theory, would be useless. Tryptophan is the serotonin precursor. We use it in conjunction with an SSRI withdrawal. The use of both an antidepressant and tryptophan is meant only for someone who is actively reducing the antidepressant. The sustained combination of both could produce a rare but potentially fatal disorder called serotonin syndrome. For that reason, unless you are actively tapering your SSRI, do not use both in combination. For withdrawal, it is helpful to build up serotonin as the medication withdrawal is occurring to lessen the withdrawal side effects. One possible symptom of antidepressant withdrawal is brain zaps. These feel like electrical discharges in the head and sometimes the body. The recommendation for someone experiencing these is to slow the withdrawal and work on building up serotonin reserves, and then going slower. Brain zaps are said to not be damaging, but they are certainly not a good sign either.